need to fear. Underdog is here.
And we're back. Fresh battery. Oh yeah. Okay. Fresh battery. Yeah, I don't know why my aftermarket battery I put in there, and from the second I put it in there, it was registering like right at the bottom, right at the lowest, you know, basically a empty bar. But oh shit. I'm a retard. Get that mixtape game. Yeah, those bike life guys, I'm telling you, they can ride, although, you know, illegal dirt bikes doing some activity I do rather casually in large group to a more higher skilled and higher, like, well, recklessness as well, higher reckless degree. You're basically scraping fender out on busy city streets. I'm a little lower around balance point. A little under chasing them out, full control, not going back as far as the fender, not going past balance point and bringing it back. That being said, they're obviously very skilled, very gifted. Does this go nowhere, or does this... Oh, okay. This goes somewhere. Yeah, the very back of Seabreeze. So yeah, okay. Well, that's where that goes. Not that interesting. Back of Seabreeze. Getting used to that with the stand-ups, the height. Ooh, man. Tell you what, top vents open. The helmet's a lot louder. I could hear it. But I am getting some airflow over my head. Authority. Come get me, bruh. Wanted to take my hand off, but I could feel I was too reliant on the handlebars, so that wasn't about to happen. But you know, I mean, I could feel the balance and how much I'm using the handlebars to maintain my position on the bike, and yeah, I could feel if I pulled off I would have yanked to the side. So yeah, I'm not there yet. That stand-up felt better, for sure. Yeah, okay, I'm almost done for the day. Okay, so I know I like this road for wheelies in general. It's a little uphill. Let's see if I could hit a fourth down here. Answer is yes. I got another spot I want to get to. That was fun. I know you. I just had to say hi to that dude. He works down where I get my haircut. He was like, hey. Oh man. A real nice. Come at me, bruh. We out here killing it. Hey. I was gonna go back and say hi to him, but he wasn't expecting me to turn around. Sometimes I like to rub bomb people on their phones to see if they'll look up. problem is down here there's even more driveways and parking lots for people to turn out of. But you know, it's got good shade cover on a hot day. It's cool to ride down here, and it's got a couple nice curves, and it's right near the lake also, which adds to the it might be the Irondequoit Bay, right near the Irondequoit Bay, which also adds to some cool air coming off the water, which is real good, real nice on a hot summer day. Oh man, there might be a couple spots where there's potential trails. Failed me. That is steep. Yeah, there is a curve at the top of that, so yeah, that's what happened to me. That one time I was like, oh, I almost went off into the grass. Well, little did I notice previously, that's a curve. Third time's the charm, right? Okay. That was pretty good. I think that tied my best for trying to wheelie up that hill. But it was good. It was good. No complaints. I mean, you gotta risk. You gotta weigh the risk with the reward. Sure, wheeling up that entire hill would be fresh to death, but at the same time, crashing on that hill might not be. Yeah, that would get real uncomfortable real fast. Closer to flat ground, so that's cool. I did bounce it. I literally bounced it. Okay, well, that's something else to practice then, just absolutely bouncing it and ripping it. Yeah, that's all. She was like, real nice. Air. Need air. Okay, so, yeah, starting out, having the wet t-shirt, and the damp t-shirt, and the damp bandana on the head, it keep you cool for about an hour or so. Then it dries out and starts evaporating, and then, yeah, still hot. Yeah, gives you a little bit. Yeah, he's a big'em. Whoa! Big man, big balls. Like, do a burnout. Definitely don't want to roll that stop. It was a me-way stop. Look at this bike. Look at this bike. It never ceases to impress me. Really love the DRZ. Thought about eventually getting a Husqvarna 701 Super Moto. But man, could I give up on this bike? I don't know. If I got this, do I get rid of the FZ09 and save this in case my wife ever wants to do a casual off-road? Then I'll have the Super Moto Husqvarna 701 Super Moto and this, so we can group ride. I don't know. But anyway, if you like my shenanigans, why don't you like, comment, subscribe to my channel? And until next time, Underdog Moto Mania.